I am unsure whether he is speaking with his mouth or his eyes as he carries on. This is weird, isn't it, Jaymi? These spaces and colours feel like they're on a screen, not around you. These vistas may be backdrops. I may turn around inside your little stone chamber and bite your neck any moment, don't you think? Something's deeply wrong, you know. It's creepy, too. Look around. Yes, it's creepy, Jaymi, isn't it? But you must allow it's alluring, so why not come and lick me and I'll switch off your head? As he swings himself around a column only 3 meters away, the moonlight flares off his big silver earring and the moisture on his canines. I'm struck once again by the unbelievable allure of Angel's eyes, finding it hard to look away from his bewitching beauty. Jaymi, he confides through his eyes or his mouth, I'm careful that you don't see my real stare of thirst through the dusk at you. My green flesh and sunken cheeks would scare you away. When you stare at the silver-mirrored windows of my black limousine, as it slithers and it oozes through the night streets, you can't see my face right in front of you, behind your own reflection, frozen in a grimace that has gripped me for hours into wet-burning shame and exhaustion in the darkness. Deep longing flickers in his mesmerizing eyes, and with that last unbearable sibilant in darkness comes a hiss among the carcass columns, as of gas in air vents, its shiver like the quiver of the shadow dagger stuck in Angel's chest, with his whisper in my ear. Stroke the blade soft on Jamie's neck while he sleeps. The air clanks thickly, every clank ringing on for many seconds, as mocking, oily voices call, Jaymi! Jaymi! Jaymi!